Sequester includes immediate cuts to federal agencies that supply security and air traffic controllers for airports across the U.S., and that includes here in Central Florida. And that could add up to big problems when it comes to local air travel. TSA screeners who check people in bags could see hours or staff members cut. The same is possible for air traffic controllers who manage airline takeoffs and landings. And a handful of smaller local airports could have their towers closed, leaving pilots to land and take off on their own. We continue our coverage now with WESH 2's Greg Fox live at Orlando International Airport. Greg, passengers are worried about safety and delays.
Yeah, and exactly, and they are all tied together. Let's give you a look at the FAA tower right there that is staffed by the federal government. And if there are reductions in the workforce there or furloughs, let's say they move them to 4-day-a-week work weeks or reduce their hours and shifts, as we give you a look back at the airfield, you can see planes this time of day, it's not quite that busy, but you're going to have a flood of planes coming in, and normally they're separated by about 2 to 3 miles coming in. If you have fewer people in the tower, they could spread that out by 5 or 10 miles. What does that mean? More delays, more headaches for passengers trying to get where they want to go.
Since 9/11, passengers have grown accustomed to the hassles and slowdowns at checkpoints, all to keep us safer. But those delays could grow starting in April. That's the earliest the federal government could begin furloughs to make up for budget cuts. Passengers tell us they're most worried about a reduction of air traffic controllers in the towers and fewer TSA screeners checking carry-ons.
We wonder whether or not they're operating efficiently and whether it's safe. I mean, if it's minimal people that's around doing the job that more people used to do, I mean, you kind of wonder about that anyway.
Safety is a priority.
Airport officials say they have an action plan in place to supplement a potential reduction in the federal screener workforce. Aviation Authority staffers will take over non-hands-on jobs like directing passengers and assisting the disabled.
We can help with the operational functions. How do passengers flow through the terminal? How do they get in line or get ready for processing?
But there's no process that will prevent potential delays to incoming international passengers who will have to wait longer if there are fewer Customs and Border Enforcement agents checking IDs and luggage. A reduction in controllers and the potential shutdown of local small airport towers in Orlando, Kissimmee, and Leesburg could cause domestic flight delays as controllers juggle planes.
It certainly would be disappointing to business travelers if we have to sit on the runway for 90 minutes to be allowed to take off.
And we are live once again at Orlando International Airport. You're getting a look at the airfield there. And a lot of passengers that we talked with today said, well, what do I do about some of this if we have more delays? You want to try to fly midweek when you can. You want to avoid flying on Mondays and Fridays. You want to try to fly earlier in the day rather than later. All these people trying to make connections through major airports like Orlando, Miami, and Atlanta, they get stuck at the end of the day. So that could help you out. Live at OIA, Greg Fox, WESH 2 News.